Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Mike Chua, physical therapist, certified dementia practitioner, and your alternative career coach. Welcome to our career healthcare podcast and show, where we talk about different ways to find your alternative career and achieve both work and financial freedom. So visit our website, drmikechua.com or alternativehealthcarecareers.com for more information. Again, thank you for watching and listening. Welcome to our show. Be awesome, be great, be excellent, ACG. Have a great day and enjoy the show. Bye-bye. All right, we are back. Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. You know how technology is. It's just amazing. If it works, it works smoothly. But if it doesn't work, of course, it doesn't work, right? But it doesn't matter how many times you failed or fallen or got sick or got booted out by Facebook. What matters is how many times you get up and do this all over again. That's why we have our special guest, Giselle Miranda. This is a continuation of that live video that we were doing earlier. We got booted out, whatever you call that. Or removed. Or whatever you call it again. Because that's how it is in life. People will say no. People will reject you. People will keep saying you are not worthy. People will continue to say you are a mess. Like what I always say, it doesn't matter how many times you failed or fallen or got sick or how they rejected you. It's how many times you get up and do this all over again. And today, let me stop that share. We have a lady who keeps on failing, but did it stop her from doing her own kids' gym? No. You know, I bet. She has failed a lot, but she keeps on doing it again and again and again. That's the key there, repetition, repetition. Because repetition is the mother of learning. It is the father of action and then the architect of results. If you want results in your life, you have to keep repeating it. Same thing with Giselle. She just keeps on repeating it. All right, Giselle, let's go back to our discussion. Where were we at? You were like, explaining how you started your kids' gym. Am I correct?
Yeah, I was. Should I start over then? Just kind of.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I was saying that a few years back, there was some changes in healthcare that was preventing kiddos from having that prolonged therapy that they needed. And so I decided to start a kids' gym that offered developmental playgroups. Kids' gym.
Oh, okay.
Sensory gym.
Gosh, I gotta clean my ears, right? Kitchen. I was like, oh, kitchen. Oh, I think it's a good idea. Let's have kids cook. I think it's a good thing to add.
We did have a little pretend play kitchen. We did have that. Mm-hmm. Well, so the groups based on the OT board, it was like group OT. So we're providing therapy just in a group setting. So the kiddos would work, you know, towards the same goals. We had groups that were fine motor, gross motor, sensory play, handwriting, using tools, you know, different things. And when the parents would come in, I would use that time to kind of educate on what the benefits are of having an OT to lead these, or a therapist, any therapist, because like I said, we all pretty much work towards the same goals. And then what the benefit was, which group would best fit their needs based on, you know, what they were reporting. And then have the kiddos work together towards their goals, socialize, and just have fun in the groups. And the best part was that we didn't have to do any documentation.
I think that's where we got cut off, right? I think Medicare. Yeah. No, oh, they said no documentation. That's no just documentation. That Facebook stream, right?
Yeah.
Well, before we keep going, I just would like to give a shout out to the people who are watching in our live stream. Melissa, thank you very much for watching. She said she's watching again. And Mr. Kari Villasica, Coach Kari, what's going on, brother? And then Melissa Stroud. Oh, she's there already. I love that, right? And Brian Cornejo, how are you there, brother? So thank you very much for watching. Again, if you're watching live, please comment live. We want to know if you are watching live and if those these videos are actually helping you. And if you're watching on the replay, please comment replay. Well, anyway, so you mentioned about no documentation, again, because you're charging cash. Am I correct?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It was charging cash, yeah.
Perfect, mm-hmm. Perfect. And earlier, before we were cut off, is that I asked Giselle, can anybody start this? Can anybody start this? And her answer was?
Absolutely. Anybody can start this.
You don't have to be a PT. You don't have to be an OT. You don't have to be a CODA or a PTA. Anybody can start this. What's the first thing that they need to do, Giselle?
Well, the first thing is decide to take that step, because, you know, that's the scary part, is actually saying, okay, I'm really going to jump in and do this. But once you're in there, I mean, things start to flow and you start to feel like it's the right thing. And you start to see the families come in and enjoy and the progress with the kiddos. And it feels right. And so, like I said, for me, it's been the best experience. And I'm excited to share with you guys. So excellent.
So I guess you guys missed the first video because we got cut off. But earlier I told her that I'm still encouraging my daughter to be a therapist, she wants to be a PT like me, but I told her to just, you know, do PTA first, learn the system, learn the process, learn the treatment ways, and then she can start her own kids gym. And we were looking at different spaces down in Jackson area, and that way we could be the best that we can be. And there's always a way. And like what Giselle mentioned, take action, guys. You know, and she mentioned the word momentum. Just like walking, you have to take that first step. You have to take that first step, and then if you keep leaning forward, what happens when you keep leaning forward? Obviously, I'm hitting my microphone, but when you keep leaning forward, you're automatically moving that. It becomes a rhythm. It becomes like a normal reaction for you now. And you feel that movement, and then bam, bam, next step. One way or another, you feel like you're ready. You can run. And that's what we want you to be. That's what you want to be when you're starting your own business. You get that momentum. But the first thing, like what she said, is to take action. Take action, just like what Melissa said. Take action, right, Mike? There you go. And before I ask the next question to Giselle, I just want to give a shout out to Mr. Dave Townsend. He's a good friend of mine. He's part of our SSHC. So thank you for watching, Mr. Dave. And then the next question, Giselle, is it really profitable? I guess, you know, that's my question, because we can, you know, when we have a business, and if that business is not making you money, it's not a business, it's a hobby, ladies and gentlemen. So when you're starting your own business, when you have what you call your entrepreneurial mindset, you have to make money out of it. And, you know, let's face it, you know, I see patients at home. I do Medicare Part B. I leverage my dementia expert class or my CDP, my certified dementia practitioner. And obviously I have to make money, because I cannot just feed my kids or my wife or my family with just words of encouragement. I still have to bring home the bacon, right? So is your business really profitable? And the next question is, how much can I make out of it?
Yeah. Well, like any business, it takes a little bit of time to build up, but absolutely it is profitable. Within my first year, I was able to make $9,000 per month. So it's all setting a plan and getting your things in order and setting yourself goals and getting yourself organized. But it takes work, but you're able to do it for sure.
Oh, wow. I don't know if you guys are listening. When I ask her, she said it takes a plan. Takes a plan. Takes what's English, right? It takes a plan. Is that the right phrase there? It takes a plan. You need to have a plan. Something like that. You need
planning.
Takes planning. Takes planning. I'm running out of English, ladies and gentlemen. It's 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. Obviously, I'm running English. You know, when I get sick, I don't want to talk English, right? But before we keep going, before I highlight what she said, I just want to give a shout out to Dr. RV Vicente. Thank you very much, Dr. RV. We appreciate you for all you do for our profession. He's actually a professor at the University of St. Augustine, creating, changing people's lives, right? Changing people's lives, whatever. You know, he's changing people's lives. being a good professor. Well, anyway, I just would like to harp on what Giselle mentioned about having a plan. Having a plan. When you're starting a business, ladies and gentlemen, you have to have the four S's. The four S's. What are the four S's? The four S's are, the first S is skills. We as therapists, whether you're a PT, OT, speech, COTA, PTA, we already have the skills. Mm-hmm. My skill is dancing. Ow. I just hurt my shoulder. My skill, oh gosh, that hurt my shoulder. I have rotator cuff syndrome. Well, let me, I just got put it out again on Facebook. Are we still live?
We're still live, looks like.
Are we still live? I'm looking at my phone and it says I'm no longer there. I guess we are. Oh, there you are. Okay, so the first S I'm looking at. So I got booted out there in my own, in our own group, Giselle. In our own group. Okay. First S is skills. You have to have that skill. So us as therapists, like what I said, whether a PT, OT, speech, PTA, COTA, we already have the skills in order for us to start that business. What's the next S? You need to have strategies. You need to have strategy. A strategy, like what she said, you have to have a plan. You know, failure to plan when you're, what do you call this? Failure to plan. When you fail to plan, you plan to fail. That's what I meant. You have to have strategies when opening up your business. So skills, strategies, right? Strategies. So the next letter, the third S, is, let me just give a shout out to Christine Mikita. Thank you very much for saying yes, you are live. So the next S, the third S. You know what? Any wild guess, Giselle? Any wild guess?
I'm not sure.
So the first is skills. Next is strategy. The third S is system. You have to have system in place. You have to have system in place. Why? Obviously, because if you don't have system in place, it's going to be hard. You know, you have to have that, you know, what time do you open up? You know, what are you going to do? You know, when there's somebody, you know, throwing up, how are you do that? Your policies and procedures and stuff like that. Right. Mm-hmm. And then the last S, what do you think, Giselle? Any wild guess? Come on, give me a good S.
Let's see.
Not C. Letter S.
Social, for the marketing aspect, the social.
Social. Yeah.
Close?
No? Yeah, that's true. Actually, that's true. You need to be social. You need to go out there. You need to go out there in your community. How can they see you if you are not social enough to be presenting yourself in your community? So aside from the S that Giselle added, I guess it's going to be 5S now, right? So the fifth S is your, actually I forgot, honestly, is support.
That's social.
That's what I meant. Support, you know, so skills, strategy, your system. She mentioned social. And last but not least, your support. You need to have a support team. A support team that will push you to your next level. And this is where Giselle comes in. She has created this course, How to Start Your Own Kids Gym. She has a group, a Facebook group, how to start it and how to do it. And let me just show it to you here. Hey, OS, what's going on? Let me show everyone the website, Giselle. There you go. So here is Giselle's website. Build your kids gym and playground business with How to Start Your Kids Gym. Oh gosh, this is really good, right? Learn the steps to starting your own sensory gym with the least upfront investment and the most profit and fun. Yep, we want fun, right? We want fun. You put the fun in functional, right?
That's right.
Leverage your therapy skills to create a gym that is uniquely positioned to build a child's mental and physical strength while earning a potential $9,000 a month. Oh gosh, I want that. Who doesn't want $9,000 a month, right? So who can start a kid's gym? Go ahead and read this, Giselle.
Pretty much everyone.
Uh-huh.
Do it, yeah.
Gosh, see, it says here yoga instructors, personal trainers, PT, OT, SCOTA, PTA, SLP. So, gosh, you know, anybody can do this. And let me just show some of the pictures. These pictures here are not stock photos. This is actually Giselle's clinic or Giselle's gym photos. Mm-hmm. Well, of course, that's not Giselle, but, you know, I wish that was Giselle climbing up there. So it's not a kid's gym anymore. It's going to be OT gym or women's gym, right? So it says here, make a change in your community. Why? Because you're not only changing your life. You're changing somebody's life when you're opening up your kid's gym. Before I keep going, OS said, how was your day? Very busy day, says OS. I want to say sister, but very, very busy day. How she's asked, or he or she is asking, how long did you live in the Philippines? I lived there pretty long. I just moved here less than 10 years ago. So I'm pretty new. I'm pretty new here in the States, OS. So thank you very much for asking. Yep, go Filipino flag. So here, build a gym for all children. All abilities, you know, promote strength, provide fun and laughter. This is what we want. My daughter, she really likes to, to tell the truth. She likes to, let me stop the share for a minute. She likes to open up her, or she wants to be in the pediatric realm when it comes to therapy. She doesn't want the geriatric because she sees me, oh, daddy's like, you know, doing those geriatric old people. I don't want old people, right? But hopefully someday she would like, you know, taking care of geriatric patient. But in her head, she wants to do pediatric. And yeah. A lot of us here, a lot of people will tell you, don't go into the therapy field. But a lot of people will tell that. Why? Because there is still in that mindset of being an employee and working for somebody else. Obviously, when you're working for somebody else, it's going to be hard right now. But if you start and create your own niche, you start and create your own business. You create your own market. Guess what? You're the one who's providing employment. You're the one who's actually changing people's life. And that's the reason why I love Giselle's program.
I think as therapists, we're so lucky to be in one of the most diverse careers out there, really. And I mean, it's just putting your mindset to finding how we can use our skill set in a different way. But there's so many things that we can do as therapists. So I think you're definitely right on that one.
Definitely. Not me, but you. Because you're doing a good job. So let's show this. I guess that's your video, right? Mm-hmm. Well, that's you there. See? Gosh, me. Where are you this? Where are you at? Looks like...
That was a Great Wall of China. I was in China there.
You started a gym in China? No, just kidding.
No. But like I said, we, thanks to this gym, we're able to travel full time as a family now. So,
oh gosh, I hate you. Stop it. Right. Well, right now, obviously, we can't. So good thing. Thank you, Corona, for us not being able to travel right now.
But I know. Imagine that. I'm so sad right now.
I know, right? But imagine that, ladies and gentlemen, because of the gym, she was able to travel before Corona, right? She was able to go to China, you know, and travel because of the gym, because she has this work-life balance. We call it work-life balance, right? So, well, anyway, I'm going to keep going. What she has in this program here. Here in her program, she will teach us how to start your kids' gym in a step-by-step, easy format. Mm-hmm. She will provide the alternative to this business. She will teach you how she made $9,000 a month. Teach me, sensei, what do you call that? Master, whatever, karate, black belt, or boss. And she will teach you how to social media your market. Use social media. How to use your social media to market your gym. This is very important. Ladies and gentlemen, you need to learn how to market yourself using social media. And that's very, very important. Because you can have the best setup, best gym, but if you don't know how to market yourself, it's going to be hard. So that's going to be one of her talking point there. Mm-hmm. Basically a lot more here. So Giselle, could you tell us how much the course is?
Well, the course is $797, and mm-hmm. It does include videos. It's 9 videos total. It's including a step-by-step guide through each step, explained on what to do, starting from how to get your LLC established, how to get all of your business established and in a row, and everything you need to open your doors. how to get insurance for your business, all that good stuff, to purchasing equipment. I mean, I provide all the equipment used with direct links so you could just click and purchase if that's the equipment you want to purchase. A guide on how to use social media to market. You get all the forms you need, liability forms, sign-up forms, automatic payment forms, all the forms you need to function in your business, a list of recommended vendors, a list of all the developmental play groups and resources that I use, a sample of my space, how I had it set up to make sure that, you know, you can use it as an example to set up a good flow in your kids gym. And you get access to our private Facebook group where we do just support for each other and just able to discuss and help through each step of the way. So
Perfect. Yeah. Hey, just the liability form, sign up forms, the automatic payment, and actually the equipment, those are actually very valuable there. And of course, the continued support that you get from DeSale, I think this is so worth it versus buying your own franchise, you know?
Yeah. I even started, I looked into franchises and it was, they would tell me $100,000, $150,000. I was like, what? Where am I going to get all that money from, you know? And so I kind of went the do-it-yourself route and was able to save so much money and able to start this off and be successful even through that route. But I could have saved a lot more too if I had a guide of how to know what to do each way, because it took me a long time to get things done, to research and know what to do. And, I lost some money doing some steps that I didn't really need to do, but I thought I did. And so it's always good to have a guide in starting something that's as big as this, as starting your business, you know?
You know what? That is so true. We need a guide. We need a guide. We don't need a franchise. I mean, obviously, if you want to buy a franchise, go ahead. You know, it's like what Giselle said. It's 100,000. The minimum is probably 50,000, and that's just the actual franchise licensing fee. In there, it's not included. The equipment is not even included. And what's bad or not bad? You know, what's funny is that you still have to pay some royalties every year, or whatever you paid, or whatever you've earned. Well, you're just basically working for somebody else.
Right.
They're making money out of you just because you're using their brand name. It's like McDonald's. Obviously, McDonald's it's a different story. But if you're gonna do it on your own, if you're gonna start a kids gym, you might as well do it on your own. Just get a guidance. You know, $7.97. I don't think that's not too much. I paid thousands of. No, just to tell the truth, I had somebody pay $10,000 just for me to teach something that actually isn't even an actionable plan. Yes, I made a mistake there, but you know, I learned from it, but it wasn't an actual concrete business. You know, it's not a brick and mortar. I paid somebody, I think $3,500 last year, to teach me how to start my own speaking business. And I was watching and listening and everything. And I technically knew what he was talking about. So with this investment, $7.97, I think this is a very good investment, ladies and gentlemen. Go grab it and just reach out to Giselle. And what website can we go to again, Giselle? Let me stop my share.
So it's here through alternativehealthcarecareers.com. You can see there and click for the kids gym, and that'll take it to my website there.
Perfect. Is there any discount code or that's it?
I believe what we're doing now is offering a little bonus to where you get the logo and website included as well. So check that out at the bottom of the page there. So
perfect. So if you buy that $7.97, you get a free website and logo and everything. Am I correct?
Yep.
Is that what? Okay. All right. So for those people who are watching, you go grab that deal. Why? Because $7.97, you get your own website. You get the actual course itself, you know, not a franchise, but still it's like you're buying that concept of franchise.
Yeah, it's like you're getting the kids gym in a box. Everything you need to get started and to kickstart your journey, you pretty much get it included there, you know, so everything you need to start.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. Well, again, thank you very much, Giselle. Any last parting wisdom or encouragement for our group here?
Yes, definitely. So I know right now we're going through this really uncertain time of, you know, what's going to happen. And it becomes a little scarier even to take a step of opening a kids gym. But I do encourage you guys to take this time even to research, you know, if this is your dream of getting a kids gym open eventually, to do your research and look into things, because everything is going to get eventually back to normal. And this is your time to kickstart this journey, to be one step ahead when it does all kind of normalize. You know, start looking into leases. Even there right now, there's even more opportunity to negotiate, you know, and start building up your clientele so that later on when you do feel ready, you can transition that into your business. Like, there are things that you can do within the safety measures that can be done, and you will be one step ahead when things normalize. So don't feel like right now you're in a standstill and you can't go towards your dreams, because you can.
Perfect. Oh gosh, I want to talk to you more then, right? So I mentioned to Giselle earlier, you know, in the middle of crisis, mm-hmm. lies an opportunity. And this is actually a great opportunity, because she asked me earlier, hey, Michael, is this the right time for us to offer this awesome product? And I said, do you know when is the right time to sell? The right time to sell and take action is now. Mm-hmm. That's the best time to take action. The best time for me to go to the gym is not tomorrow. It wasn't yesterday. Actually, now. Same thing with you. If you're watching right now, I don't know. I'm not looking at my cell phone. If you're watching right now, if you really want to start your kids' gym, you gotta take action now. Why? Because this is the perfect timing. Giselle asked me, hey, Michael, is this the right timing? Yes, actually, yes. Why? Because all this realtor that is wanting for their spaces to be leased out, they're going to offer you some lease program. That the one lease that I'm looking at Jackson, they're willing to give me at least a whole year free rent just to close in the contract for 3 years. Yeah. Duh. You know, I mean, imagine that. And that's what Giselle is going to talk about in her course, how to leverage your relationship, your skills, and how to bring back to your community. Right. Thank you very much, Giselle. Anything else?
Nope. I think that's it. Thank you so much, Mike, for having me.
All right. Again, thank you very much, Giselle. I appreciate you. But before I let you go, ladies and gentlemen, always remember the word fast, F-A-S-T. Why? Because you want to take action fast. Like what I mentioned earlier, take action fast. Letter F. Is that letter F? Letter F.
Fordham.
Letter F. Find friends that will push you to your next level, because you are the average of the five people you hang out with. So who are you hanging out with? Are you hanging out with awesome people? Guess what? You're going to be awesome. Right now, I'm hanging out with Giselle. I want to know what she's doing, because I want this for my daughter, who is going to be a PTA, my eldest daughter, and then my second daughter, she wants to be a CODA. And I encourage them to be still a PTA and CODA. So if they decide to be a OTR or a PT someday, they already have their own business like this, right? So find friends that will push you to your next level, all right? Next letter is letter A. You'll learn how to take action. Take action. You know, just like the director says, you know, I have that TV show in the Philippines. I don't know if you guys are following. I've been sharing it. The director would always say, lights, camera, action. You may have your lights ready. I'm going to show you my lights. Oh, gosh, my shoulder hurts. I have lights there, right? Your lights may be ready. Your camera may be ready. But if you don't take action, guys, that movie will not show. That movie will not roll. You got to take action. You got to take action. All right. So next letter is letter S. Letter S. Shoot for the moon. Why? Because if you keep shooting for the moon, you're going to miss it. You're going to be landing with the stars. Right now, I miss shooting for the moon. I'm landing with a star named Giselle Miranda. She's a star right now, right? And last but not the least, letter T. Letter T. Timeout. Not timeout. Oh, gosh. What's letter T? Teach it. You got to learn how to teach it. Why? Because when you hear it, you forget. When you see it, you remember. But when you're actually teaching it, you're actually understanding it more. And that's what Giselle is going to do with us. She's going to teach us how to start your own kids gym. So go grab that offer there. It's awesome. It's very affordable. You know, go take action fast. F-A-S-T. Again, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate you, Giselle. Thank you very much. I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to share that music. And then we are signing off. Be awesome. Be great. Be excellent, ACG. And we will see you around. I hope you enjoyed the show. Check out our website at drmikechua.com or alternativehealthcarecareers.com for more information. Again, ACG, be awesome, be great, be excellent. Thank you, and hope to see you on our next episode. Goodbye.